Susie Whittington from the Homeless Veterans Program at Etowicoke Veterans Hospital. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, we've got a big day Saturday, don't we?
The biggest one of the year for me.
You ready?
You know, I'm in the home stretch.
A lot of planning going into this, I know.
Yeah, this wipes out Christmas. I mean, this is just over the top.
It's the homeless stand down, and it will be Saturday at Togus.
At Togus, so at the VA campus. This is our 20th year, so it's the homeless veteran stand down. Stand down is a military term. Mm-hmm. So veterans or persons in combat, it started in Vietnam, during Vietnam. They would come off the battlefield. They'd get a day off. So they would get, you know, showers and meals.
Getting everything taken care of.
Yeah, that, and just you get out of kind of the trenches of the war, of combat. So the Homeless Stand Down is a national event that happens across VA hospitals and community partners. And we take homeless veterans off the streets, out of the shelters, out of their cars, their trucks, their tents, wherever they may be. And we bring them in for a full day of services.
And there's transportation available all around the state, right?
Yep. Yeah, our posters are hopefully everywhere. Mm-hmm. They've been sent to every shelter, the food pantries, general assistance offices. Hopefully you're seeing them in Hannaford's across the state. We will bring in our veterans free of charge. We'll put them on the bus. We'll bring them in. We'll give them breakfast. We will welcome them. We'll tell them a little bit about the day, and the day that they will have is going to be phenomenal. We are going to offer them primary care visits, flu shots, optometry, reading glasses, dental screenings, prosthetics.
The list is amazing.
It really is. It grows.
Yeah. It grows. How are you doing all of this in one day, you know?
So I have the most committed group of volunteers. I have over 200. I've probably had to turn away for like 40. And then they're really, and I'm like, I'm so sorry.
But that's a nice problem to have, to turn away volunteers.
It's a great problem. We will have people to assist our homeless veterans with employment and housing and tax advocates, free lawyers. We'll help them write up their advanced directives telling their medical providers what they want in case they're unable to do so.
One of the key things I saw, too, is that women's services. I mean, this is available for men and women.
Absolutely.
Veterans. Yeah, so
we're opening it up to families this year. So if we have a homeless veteran with children, they can bring their children and we'll have activities for the kids to do.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yep. So we didn't want that to be a barrier. You name it. Main care will be there.
And then a full dinner provided, too.
Oh, the Elks Lodge, the Augusta Elks, and now Waterville to cook up turkeys. I mean, they're up all night cooking these turkeys. So they'll get a hot turkey dinner, cranberry stuffing, baked potatoes, the works. When the veterans are done with the services for the day, we will take them out to the back behind one of our buildings. There'll be a tent full of brand new winter clothing, boots, socks, sweatpants, sweat tops, coats, hats, mittens, canteens for water, flashlights. Everything that kind of just to help them get ready for winter, because a lot of them are in really unsafe situations.
Yeah. You know, it's unfortunate that we have to have a day like this.
I know.
But it just warms my heart, all the stuff that you're doing.
Well, it's such an opportunity because veterans, you know, the resources are there, but they're not always ready to come in. Mm-hmm. And I get that. So this is a way to welcome them.
Some people have a hard time asking for help.
Help, and it can be hard. There are rules that sometimes come with help, and if you've been living off doing your own thing, that can be tricky. Some people are struggling with addiction and mental illness.
Sure.
We have all of those supports there that day. So every year, I have volunteers that were homeless that came to Stand Down.
And then come back and help?
And they come back and help.
Oh, that's awesome.
And
that's
our keynote,
most powerful message. Yeah.
That is. Our keynote speakers. Now, we have lots of fabulous VIPs in the Augusta area. Mm-hmm. But our VIP speakers are veterans who are homeless and have flipped their lives around, and they come and speak because that's what really matters.
And that's where you need to get that voice out. Did say we did
been there,
it.
Yeah.
You can do it. And you can do help it. You how, and show you how.
So whatever the barrier is to getting housed, we're going to have the resources there to serve our veterans. So radio is a great way for us to reach those vets who are kind of what I might call off the grid. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not in a shelter. They're not in transitional housing. They're probably on the river. They're under the bridge. Mm-hmm. So hopefully they're listening. And please come this Saturday between 8 and 3. The sooner you get there, the more resources we'll have available to get you because through the day, it's a very busy day. But we really want to invite our homeless
vets
in. And again,
these flyers are everywhere. Hannaford, you mentioned, right?
Yeah, so we're putting them
in every corner so you can find
across the state.
Yeah, all the information right there. And of course, we do have it at 92moose.fm. Just click on a community. Again, it's the Homeless Stand Down Saturday, Togus VA. Susie Whittington just does such an amazing job with the Homeless Veterans Program at Togus, and it's always wonderful to see you. Thank you for all your work.
Well, thank you for having me and really getting the word out to our homeless vets.
Absolutely.
That's big piece.